to TV Burp. Sandy kneading the groin by a ghost on Emmerdale. Man laughs like a sheep on the hottest place on earth.
And is it me just imagining it, or do your feet feel really hot?
Yeah.
And Viagra overdose on Dancing on Ice.
I got a lump earlier when I was skating. Mine, I got another lump watching.
The Apprentice is back. So without further ado, let's meet one or two of the apprentices. There's Ben.
For me, making money is better than sex.
You're not doing it right. There's Noral.
I love the sound of my own voice. At work, I stand out from the crowd. I look the part, I talk posh, and I look posh.
You're not posh. There's Kimberly.
I am a rough, tough cream puff from New York.
You're a donut. This series is slightly different. Yeah, the teams aren't quite equal.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to my boardroom. Now, those astute ones amongst you will notice that the chaps are one man short. There's 8 girls and only 7 boys. And that's because someone's already bottled it.
Yeah, they're a man short, and I can reveal now exclusively who that person is. Come on out.
I'm a rough, tough cream puff from Albert Square, but it just wasn't for me. Besides, they had me sharing a room with that posh bloke.
Oh, well.
Can I have a go on the...
No, you can't. Sir Alan is nothing if not tough.
You think you can second guess or play me? Well, let me tell you. I'm as hard to play as a Stradivarius. And you lot, I can assure you, are as easy to play as bongo drums.
I love to play my bongos in the morning. In the evening? No, in the morning. Very, very big on the funky house scene. He's not one for being talked round, Sir Alan. No, he can't stand the la-di-da types.
It could be, of course, that you're here because you're good with words. You know the right thing to say at the right time. I mean, I know the words to Candle in the Wind. Don't make me Elton John, right?
And it seems to me that you live your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to turn to when a rain to end. Instrumental solo! The task was to set up a cleaning company. The brief was broad. They could clean whatever they thought they could get paid for.
Carpets.
Office carpets.
What about shoes? But
dry cleaning.
I like windows.
I wonder if we can clean people.
Yeah. Yeah. Thanks very much. Yeah. Yeah. I was particularly impressed with Kate's telephone technique. Yeah, she was able to look straight ahead and talk into the phone just by altering the angle of her mouth.
Hello? OK, right, just a bit of an update for you. I'm afraid there's been a slight change of plan here.
It's really grafted.
It's in a nutshell.
We haven't got the additional 10 calls. Yeah, I was very pleased. Of the service, and I wondered if I could book in a bed part of the call. Yeah, I could, special luck. The boys won this week, yes, and Sir Alan's treat for them was those 2 bartenders off Britain's Got Talent. are good, those two. But if you didn't catch The Apprentice... The Apprentice this week, don't worry. We're offering a new item that we call this week's Apprentice in a Nutshell. This week's
Apprentice in a Nutshell. I'm the complete package. I've got the rainbow of skills that nobody else will have. It's my opinion people are going to want, and it's my business card they're going to want at the end of the night.
Anita, you're fired.
Let's just find out what's happening down at Monkey World in Dorset. A great day out for all the family!
Will Keeper Holly ever get the sample she's waiting for?
Pee, Paquita.
Come on. Pee, pee, pee.
Very exciting. We'll come back to it. There were a couple of chimpanzees reenacting the opening titles of Hawaii 5-0 on Monkey Life this week.
When Cherry enters the bedroom and meets the group...
I wonder how Holly's getting on collecting that,
Pee, Paquita.
Come on. Pee, pee.
Still no luck. Yes, I've actually been thinking of getting a monkey myself. Yeah, nothing too big, perhaps something like a marmoset. But what are the pros and cons?
Mad Max the Marmoset has lived with Sandra and her family in Stoke for just 6 months.
You can see what Max is like. Very cheeky, wants to come out all the time. None of the kids will come in the room with him because he jumps straight on them and bites their ears. He causes quite a lot of damage as well. They do smell, they smell horrific. I think he's took me as his mate. He tries to mate with the back of my head constantly.
Get off me! What? No, you can't have a go on the jelly. Don't encourage him. Oh, hang on, I think Holly may have had a breakthrough.
Pee, Paquita. Pee.
And if you keep trying, eventually you'll succeed.
Good girl. Good girl.
Very Moorish. Which brings us to our TV Burp Stars of Tomorrow Today.
TV Burp Stars of Tomorrow Today.
What's your name?
Christopher. What's yours?
And congratulations to Ray Quinn on winning Dancing on Ice. Of course, he couldn't have done it without the help of Jane Torvill and,
Christopher.
Christopher Dean. Yes. Christopher Dean. And if 2 solid months of Dancing on Ice wasn't enough for you and you hanker for more, Philip Schofield had some news.
How would you like to see the stars of Dancing on Ice on tour?
No, you're all right. Probably enough, wasn't it? Quite sufficient. It was a week of surprises on EastEnders.
I'm not trying to, you know, it's not conservation.
Have you got your homework back?
For education for anybody else.
Fancy doing some reading?
Reading? On the square? Has Ricky gone mad? Let's see how Liam got on.
Just read the damn book, will you?
I hate you!
Ah, back to normal. Since Knitted character joined the square, there's been a couple of other new characters. There's Piggly.
Daniel, you ain't seen Chops, me pig.
No.
Charlie reckons he didn't do it, but someone must have let her out. She's been out all night and she can't sleep without Piggly.
All right, Piggly?
Yes, I.
Then there was the bowl... Then there was the bowl-headed girl.
Right, let's set the, table.
Oh, you magic!
All right, bowl-headed girl. Yeah. Yeah. Two new characters.
There was an interesting dilemma for Abby.
By the way, you? I'm hungry.
Yeah, sorry, I've run over at Booty's, so I'll just do us some pasta, shall I?
Pasta? That's coming around. It's spring and curry.
No, no, it's not.
Why not?
Because it's pasta or nothing.
Yeah, well, I like pasta, but then I like nothing. But which is better? There's only one way to find out. See you after the break. Things get childish on the bill.
Girls, you smell.
Holby actors, watch Holby on Holby.
Do we have to watch the whole thing through?
Mm-hmm. That's it.
And confused blind man on Casualty.
I might be blind, but I see ya. I see all of ya.
Well, you're not blind then, are you? I wonder what Heston Blumenthal is planning for his Roman feast. Something weird, I'll be bound.
We're actually making pork scratchings.
Oh, well, pork scratchings? Great, I love them. Yeah, let's try one. Lovely.
We're actually making pork scratchings, but from nipples.
Sorry, oh, yeah, that came as a bit of a shock, aren't they? I'm not bad, no. Well, I'll tell you what would go nice with those. A rusk. Keep up. The Marquis of Bath seemed to like them anyway.
I love pork scratchings, and I'm always complaining that it's not scratchy enough. And so I love it when I find it scratchy.
One way of putting it. Yeah. He has a real habit of putting his finger right on it, the Marquis of Bath.
I'm finding them delicious.
Yeah. I'm so pleased, Your Lordship.
There were plenty of things there that were doing things to me there.
All right, that's enough. When's the last bus back to Longleat? In an attempt to discover new things to do with pork, Heston travels to Italy, where he meets pork expert Pepe Cotto.
This is Pepe Cotto.
Great to meet you.
I play a trombone.
Yeah, I've never played the pork trumpet. Please. I wonder if there's any other pork-based instruments. Well, there's the pork trumpet, of course. That's right. Then there's the ribs. Yeah, and then of course there's a little pigtail. The porkestra there. Porkestra. You can play pretty much anything except Hava Nagila. So, what was on the menu finally? You're taking the mick. Still, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. I rest my case. Which brings us to a TV highlight of the week. TV highlight
of the week. Reza,
Do you have any particular strengths you can bring to the course today?
Not particularly, no.
Coronation Street now. And it was the week of the opening of Tara's new art gallery. Yeah, and there was wine and everything. Not sure it was necessarily the best wine money can buy.
At this rate, I won't even cover the cost of the Cabernet.
Well, come on. Well, this isn't like sending a packet of fish fingers. I mean, people don't like to look, to muse, to ponder.
Excuse me?
Huh?
Yes?
Could my wife possibly use your loo? Wine goes straight through her.
Still a cheap night out. It's a cheap night out. Tony appeared to have got himself caught whilst stewing up his flies.
Fine. Leave me alone. Go back to work.
I felt that. Might need a little bit of Savile on it.
Could my wife possibly use your loo? Wine goes straight through her.
Not without a doctor's note. Go on, get out. Hairdresser Natasha was set by the... Hairdresser Natasha was set quite a challenge in the hairdressers this week.
Right, Barbara. What can I do for you?
Make me look like Scarlett Johansson.
Yeah, good luck with that. Mm. The girl with the pearl hearing aid. Peter Barlow was worried that his carton of milk might be late for school.
Come on, mate, you're going to be late for school.
Yeah, truancy amongst milk cartons is a growing problem. Yeah. Gotta move on. You'll be late for school. I don't want another parents meeting at the last one. His grades had really slipped. Then we found out he was being bullied by a tub of single cream. Yeah, I went down the school, turned out the cream was the son of the drama teacher and the head refused to act. Paris Hilton's British best friend now, and I was surprised to see Paris's long, different coloured legs. One flesh-coloured, one bright red.
Thank you, everyone. I know this is really hard. It's hard for me. This is the first elimination that I've tried and I'm not okay. Yeah.
Yeah. All right, Paris? Yeah. Last week, Paris pretended that the show was over and that she wouldn't be choosing a British best friend after all, which, of course, provoked unparalleled sadness from her would-be friends.
Dear Emma, I hate doing this in a letter.
Something came up back home and I have to go back to LA.
As you know, the final is going to be in the US, so you have to make a decision about who to take.
I'm really sorry, but you won't be coming to LA to be my big British best friend. So I'm going home.
I'm feeling it, Paris. Trust me, and who was my only friend when I needed it.
I just
felt like it's really unfair because I've tried so hard, and
it's very sad. Carrie was probably the most upset of any of the contestants to be going home. Well, she had strong feelings for Paris.
I love you so much.
I know. I love you too.
I think you're so beautiful and so sweet. Almost too sweet for LA. Like, I'm scared that they'll eat you up.
I'm sorry, I'm squeezing your hand so tight.
I love you.
I already love you.
Is love? The final three were given the rare treat of visiting Paris at her home in LA, and it's quite a gaffe.
Wow.
My walk-in closet has four rooms. It's easy to get lost.
Well, get lost in. There was one last treat for the BBFs before the final decision was made.
Pulled up outside Planet Hollywood, where there was a big sign saying Paris Hilton on the red carpet tonight. We were like, oh, my God, it's the showing of her film.
I thought we weren't supposed to mention the film. So, who did win the coveted prize of Paris Hilton's British Best Friend?
At the end of every elimination, I say that I have to get back to my life and that I hope one of you will join me one day. And tonight, finally, one of you will be joining me. My new British best friend is...
Harry Hill.
Me? Paris! It's all right, Paris. I've got ya. Whoops! Talk to you never. Yeah, I was voted Paris Hilton's British best friend. Oh, I can't wait till she gets out of hospital.
In the absence of your love, I have decided that I'm throwing my arms around all of Paris Hilton's old stone. Steel, except my love. I'm throwing my arms around. I'm Paris because, Paris because.
Oh, you're sure you're Paris Hilton, aren't you?
No, I'm Scarlett Johansson.
That's all from this year. See you next week.
The Harry Hill TV Burp Gold DVD is available in store and online. And coming up here on ITV1.
I bet I can read your mind. You want to know who we are, what the arc is, and what the big flickering thing is behind me, right?
Find out exactly who he is in the new series of Primeval next.